So maybe you want to be a trader. You want to be the kind of person that is completely in charge of your financial future, and you just want to look at the markets. So many people that I come across every week, every month, have that dream, whether they are looking to come out of the workforce and just have a new career or retire, or some people that are just completely starting their career, just coming out of college, just want to trade or invest in the markets. And so I thought I would just take a couple minutes and talk a little bit about that. And you know, for some people that just really feels like a pipe dream where it's just completely not real. But instead of making this sort of a rah-rah and hyping up and, you know, making this a video where, you know, I'm gonna try to pretend like it's easy and you could just put on a trade and buy a new car, you know, tomorrow, which is completely not the way it works. It's still a lot of work. I thought I would just make the first video of what I think is gonna become a series and talk about, you know, how to live a happy life as a trader. And again, I don't want to focus on this being, you know, some sort of ridiculous way to just become ultra wealthy overnight. It's not. But there are a couple things in which you can make this a lot easier than a lot of people ultimately may end up making it. And one big thing is to have realistic expectations. But the easiest way to basically dampen those realistic expectations over time is by becoming a trend fighter. And you know, I think a lot of people fall into the category where they are scared to buy something after it's gone up too much or think the trend can't continue. So there's that whole notion of mean reversion that a lot of people believe in, myself including. But there's a big difference between thinking that something has to crash after having gone up a little bit or a lot, and by just playing the mean reversion. And so let me just quickly flip over to the chart. We can move over to the screen here. And I'll just quickly show you this. And then this is just the S&P 500. But to keep it simple, you know, what a lot of people do, or to keep my example simple, is they will look at a chart, and this could be anything, right? And every time it goes up a little bit, they think it gets overbought and they're scared to buy. So they might even short it, right? And then it doesn't go down and it quickly reverses back up and they try to short it again and again and again. And yes, there are these mean reversion moves, but most people lose money in the markets because they are fighting these long trends. How many times have you looked at a chart and you said, okay, I'm gonna buy when it gets here. And then the next time you look at it, a few weeks, a few months later, it's like up 30, 40, 50, 100%. That happens a lot. And so the more you respect the trend, the easier your life becomes as an investor. Trust me, take it from my book. I've done this for a long time, and I've for a long time was really a mean reversionist, but also a trend fighter. Mean reversionist isn't so bad because you tend to do small trades against maybe a predominant trend, but someone who just wants to fight the trend, there are plenty of people. There are people that I personally know in this business, hedge fund managers, mutual fund managers that have gone out of business over the past 5 years because they were fighting a very, very strong bull market. So you don't want to be one of those people. Another way of looking at it is, you know, there's a statistic out there that talks about that more money is lost in the markets by people who are anticipating a correction than they would lose otherwise once the correction actually happens. So that constant fearfulness of markets dropping, and by the way, this also happens in the opposite direction. If you're in a bear market and you're constantly thinking we're gonna get back into a bull market, fighting that trend and constantly trying to buy the dip and then you get punched in the face again is the same problem. So respect the trend. And I think, you know, that over time, at least over the course of my 22, 23 career so far, is probably one of the best advice I can give you to make your life as a trader and investor as easy as possible. Again, it's not easy. It's hard to make money in the markets. But I think by becoming a trend fighter, again, different from a mean reversionist, but a trend fighter, I think is a very, very difficult way to make money. So the trend is your friend. Respect the trend. And I think with that, you'll make things a lot easier than it has to.